Master trainers will be used to train the sarpanchas, as you have planned. We would like to take as it is. They will be used to train the master sarpanches, maybe the MPTCs also. Sarpanches and MPTCs both. And the devotees will only train the ward members. Now these devotees will in turn be trained by the same mandal trainers, as you said. Master trainers, that's fine for us. So master trainers will train the devotees and they will also train the sarpanches and MPTCs.
Yeah.
That's fine. And again here that 15 and 30 also we would like same 50% ex elected representatives and 50% other professionals. Similarly, we would like this group another at another level 50% women in all these, no? Master trainers or devotees, we would like women. Then we would like them to be inclusive, having, you know, elements from ST, SC, BC and others. So these are the basic things which we have to, mostly it will be under the district training center. We have to quickly form the district training councils and then, you know, tell them maybe have use this, your Mana TV or video conference and then advise them so that, you know, or maybe they, we can call them for one day meeting at regional level at ETCs. The district training councils can all be called, five ETCs, we can call them there and then we can explain them and train them so that, you know, they will go and start the process. This can be, this should be done very, very immediately. Next, is this the next one? Yeah. So this is again, you know, this is about basically one, again, you know, training inputs, your program. You will explain, you know, the structure as we said, the constitutional basis, Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat, Sarpanch and Gram Panchayat Secretariat, four elements of Panchayat. We need to, I do not know, you have material for all this?
Yes, sir.
Ready-made material?
Yeah, yeah.
All these four, this can be one session.
In fact, last 4 or 5 months we have been doing that. We knew one day or the other, trainings will, I mean, elections would be thrown.
Yeah.
And we don't want to lose time after the elections, conducting the training needs assessment, printing books, etc.
Yeah.
So we are prepared, we are ready.
So, yeah. Next is the ecosystem in which Jilla Gram Panchayat functions today. The Panchayat Raj family, their, you know, relationship, Gram Panchayat to MPP to JDPP to the District Planning Committee. One by one alliance will line. Then, see, the today activist groups have become very, very important players in the at every level, including Gram Panchayat level. They are, of course, SHGs, community-based organizations, NGOs. We need to give them some inputs on this. Then about the press, because this is also very, very important. Now, press has become very active, even at village level or your mandal level, people will go and interact. So we have to also, you know, tell them, you know, what is this press and how press functions, what are stringers, you know, they will not know what is the difference between stringer and a reporter and a correspondent and a bureau chief and things like that. So they should know, you know, how press works, the people. Then next will be the panchayat department itself. You know, what is the, their you know, regular parenteral. The DPO, the DLPO, the EO, what do they do and where do they stay and all about that. Then finally, you know, other things like, you know, RTI, Lokayukta. RTI is, of course, the village level, they are also subject to the RTI Act. So then, yeah, then they should know a little bit of RTI Act. Then we have made Lokayukta as some kind of an ombudsman in Andhra Pradesh. So we should tell them, you know, what Lokayukta does, you know, how they gather information. How they conduct their investigation and how they arbitrate the cases. And generally about the courts. Writ petitions, are the panchayat bodies subject to the writ petitions? Major panchayat untai kada? Major panchayat untai kada? So people should know what they should do when they have an interface with the court. Yeah.
Next one.
Broadly speaking, that is this. Then bookkeeping. This is a very important thing. What are all the, according to the code now, what are the records we need to list down, you know, record 1, record 2, record 3, record 4, like that, and explain them. Very, very important thing. Without knowing this, I think we will not be able to progress much. Then next, accounting system. How accounting system, you know, if revenues are collected, okay, you got revenue, today 10,000 rupees are collected, and then there is also a need, some work has come, can you pay? What is the method? How you account the revenues and how you expend and how do you write, you know, that is how it goes about accounting system, you know, your money is coming in and going out. So there is a model accounting system now.
Yeah, yeah,
no, so the this has to come from the you know, domain people, that is the panchayat people. The commissioner of panchayat should ensure that, you know, the book, what is the bookkeeping, what is the accounting system today, all that should come from there.
Priya soft, etc.
We will come to that also. Yeah. That is also there separately. Yeah, next. Yeah, this e-panchayat. In e-panchayat, what are the modules and what are the things required for that and how they can use this particular thing. So this has to be an input. Then regulatory functions. Now, we of course, we have explained that there is a DPO, there is a DLPO, there is a PO, Panchayat RD. But then, you know, what happens if there is a complaint? There is a complaint about misuse, there is a complaint about non-remitting of revenues, there is a complaint about any irregularity in the sanction of a work or in implementation of a work or in maintenance of something. You know, these are the regulatory functions. Who can come and inquire and look into their functioning? No, that is basically, you know, the panchayat wing and then the lokayukta. So that act provisions, you know, wherever the act provisions, okay. Now these people can do it, what are the remedies available? If, okay, some panchayat officer comes, inspects and says, you know, check power is seized or, you know, something has happened, and if the panchayat feels otherwise, what is that relief they can do? Which are the provisions, under which provisions they can seek the relief? From which authorities they can seek the relief? This is a basic thing, and again, perhaps panchayat CPR Safi should provide the inputs for this also. Yeah. Then this is about, you know, levy collection and appropriation of revenues. We talked about accounting. Same thing, you know, how you levy, little beyond accounting, it becomes a finance function. Levying revenues, collecting it, appropriating it, you know, how do you adjust it, revenues. That can be one capsule input. Then next, building and maintenance of drinking water systems. This can be one separate individual component input. Then next, sanitation, latrines, drainage and sweeping. Basically, all these functions, how they get done, from where they make money and how they procure the services and how they account for it. All about this. Then similarly, internal roads. This will, I mean, all these things involve the entire range of about these particular activities. What are the internal roads and who owns them? What kind of internal roads? Gravel, metal, BT, cement, different castings, and how to maintain them and all that. Sizes, dimensions. Next, street lighting. Similarly, what is the street lighting and how do they do? Directly give it from the power, or you'll have a separate dedicated line? What will be the electricity charges? What are the government instructions about the electricity charges? How much you need to pay and how you need to pay and things like that. All about street lighting. Then this is about the town and country planning and the building permissions. This has become very, very important in the bigger panchayats now. Hardly they have any idea about this particular thing. How the building permissions are given? Is it just, okay, sarpanch, wherever he likes, he gives it, or there is a procedure according to the rules, the gram panchayat need to pass a resolution, according to the resolution, the permission is given, and then what is the town and country planning department, and how those principles have to be applied while giving a layout permission. So maybe we can take some inputs from the town and country planning, find some rules which are there in the CPR and make this capsule. Next, engineering works. Broadly speaking, you know, engineering was basically there will be a sanction, there will be a technical sanction, there will be an administrative sanction, there will be a working plan, working estimate, then there will be work execution, there will be MBOKs, and then there will be bills will be passed and payments will be made. Who all does all these things? This entire thing, it should have a component. Then there some engineering inputs can come, engineering department can give these inputs and it can be there. Next. Now this is again as in the ecosystem we have already mentioned, which are all the government departments. There are about 42 government departments. We can just list them, you know, these are the 42 government departments and these are the things which they do and what is their village level presence, basically to give some idea. Then this is about the schemes, you know, some important schemes. Education, Rajiv Gandhi, Sarva Siksha Abhiyan, Rural Health Mission, ICDS, Anganwadis, MNREGA, pensions, insurance scheme. Then in agriculture, articles, the seed schemes, fertilizer, mechanization, input subsidy, insurance, etc. All those things. You know, some of the important schemes, do we, if you have, fine. Otherwise, we need to just gather some information and put it as one capsule. That's it. So these are the things which we want.
Can I get your permission now?
Please.
This is one trend that we develop. On that basis, we then develop another workshop, the content based upon the issues that they have listed out. This is a problem that confronted, what kind of development we can do to resolve this issue. So that enters into the course content. And that would become session planning.
Anyway, you have given the course content now, you said.
Sir.
We have to see whether we have all these components.
Yes, right. We have given
pen drives.
Yeah. So once that is done, for the writer's workshop again is vetted. One of the sets we have recently given it to our then Asian government. So that is there. That's coming here. We have copy from Mr. Manikrishna also. These contents, also besides this, the guidelines from the DRGF, etc., the National Capacity Building Framework has enlisted some of the topics that sir has mentioned in terms of constitution, etc. All of them are already enlisted there, which are being implemented in the last couple of years. We are now introducing the same thing as part of the course this year also. So, to that extent, we are...
In about 2-3 days time, you see that, you know, the syllabus, if there are any modifications required, additions required, deletions required, please tell them so that they will
take this. Sir, I think tomorrow itself we can find.
Yeah.
Already purchased.
Then these have gone into the ready reckoner concept also. I have ready the handout written is there in which all these topics are mentioned.
In fact, sir, we have gone one step ahead and we have prepared a very small FAQ booklet. Jomina Petkunedi Vastun sir Dini Mida. Neer evaithe ippudu chupicharo vaatannit meeda kottaga ennikainatundi oka sarpanch ko ward member ko elanti anumanalu raavachu anedi uhinchi. ఇది కూడా మనం ఊహించింది కదా సార్ ఆ టీఎన్ఏలో వీ కాల్ పీపుల్ ఫ్రమ్ వేరియస్ వాక్స్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ ఇన్ అది పంచాయతీరాజ్ డొమైన్ అండ్ వాళ్ళందరినీ పిలిపించి వాళ్ళల్లో ఎలాంటి ప్రశ్నలు ఉత్పన్నం కావచ్చో ముందే ఊహించి వీ మేడ్ ఏ స్మాల్ బుక్ పబ్లిష్ ఇవి వీ విల్ గో హెడ్ అండ్ ప్రింట్ అబౌట్ అ ల్యాక్ ఆఫ్ డెత్ చిన్నగా ఇంతే ఉంటుంది సార్ డైరీ లాగా ఇన్ కేస్ సర్పంచ్ గెట్స్ ఎ డౌట్ ఆ ప్రశ్న దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళి ఆ రెడీ రెకనర్ లాగా చూసుకోగలుగుతాడు ఇట్స్ ఎన్ ఎఫ్ఏక్యూ Next.
So, then the buttons that the films that are there as part of all these things. So, to the extent of the services concerned, sir, some of the, for example, the list of departments in the village level present that you have mentioned, these have been also, because in one of our village studies, we have come out with the number of organizations present at the panchayat level. We have listed from varying from 18 to 32 of them and the positions that are there in the studies. So, this goes into the understanding, sir. List of government departments, maybe we will add.
We will pick up and get the at least captions to spend it. Yes.
Right now, we are not in a position to do that. So basically, on the basis of DNA, on the basis of workshops, these have been done. National Capacity Building Framework is always kept in mind, which ensures the inclusion of all the topics concerning constitutionalism. They are very clearly mentioned. RTI, we have also included, there are specialized movements that participate, they are used to be there. And they become part of the ready reckoners which are there. So this is the ready reckoner kind of the folks.
చూడండి ప్రాసెస్ డాక్యుమెంట్ అది ఒకసారి యాక్సెస్
దిస్ ఈస్ ట్రైనర్స్ మాడ్యూల్
నేను చెప్పాను సార్ ఇంకొంచెం క్లారిటీ చూడండి సార్ ఇది ఇదేమో ట్రైనర్స్ కి మనం ఇచ్చేటువంటి మాడ్యూల్ ఇదేమో యాక్చువల్ గా మాన్యువల్ టు ద సర్పంచ్ కరదీపిక ఒకటి మార్గదర్శిని ఒకటి కరదీపిక ఒక పేజీలు తిరిగే
Thank you.